Why is the moon moving away from Earth? Have you ever looked up at the moon and wondered if it would ever move away from Earth? Well, you're not alone, and the answer might surprise you. The moon is moving away from us. Scientists have been studying this phenomenon for decades, and the reasons are fascinating. Let's dive into the question on everybody's mind. Before we get into the science behind it, let's take a quick look at the history of our moon. One of the prevailing theories is that the moon formed around 4.5 billion years ago, shortly after the formation of the solar system. The current leading theory suggests that the moon formed from debris left over after a Mars-sized object collided with Earth, sending debris into space that eventually coalesced to form the moon. This collision would have had a profound impact on Earth, likely causing massive disruptions to the planet's climate and geology. The moon's gravitational pull also affects Earth's tides and may have played a crucial role in the development of life on Earth. Over time, the moon has continued to evolve and change, shaped by impacts from asteroids and comets and by volcanic activity. The moon's surface is covered in craters, mountains, and vast plains, providing a record of its history and evolution. Since then, the moon has been orbiting around Earth, exerting a gravitational pull that causes the tides to rise and fall. But over time, scientists have noticed that the moon's orbit is slowly getting larger. This means that the moon is moving away from Earth at a rate of about 3.8 centimeters per year. Reasons why the moon moves away from Earth. So why is this happening? The answer lies in two main factors: the moon and Earth rotation, and the gravitational interaction between the moon and the Earth. This phenomena is known as the lunar recession, and it is caused by the rotation of the moon and Earth. To understand how this happens, we first need to understand the basic principles of gravity and orbital mechanics. As the moon orbits around Earth, it exerts a gravitational pull on our planet, but Earth also exerts a gravitational pull on the moon. This tug of war between the two celestial bodies causes the moon's orbit to become elliptical. And as the moon's orbit becomes more elliptical, its distance from Earth increases. This is because the gravitational force between the moon and Earth is weaker when the moon is farther away. The gravitational force between two objects depends on their masses and the distance between them. The larger the masses of the objects, the greater the gravitational force between them. The closer they are, the stronger the gravitational force. The moon's orbit around the Earth is not a perfect circle, but rather an ellipse. This means that the moon is sometimes closer to the Earth and sometimes farther away. When the moon is closer to the Earth, the gravitational force between them is stronger, which causes the moon to accelerate slightly. This acceleration causes the moon to move slightly ahead of its predicted position in its orbit. As the moon moves ahead of its predicted position, it experiences a gravitational tug from the Earth's equatorial bulge. This bulge is caused by the rotation of the Earth, which causes its equator to bulge out slightly. This gravitational tug causes the moon to slow down slightly, which causes it to move slightly farther away from the Earth. This process of the moon moving slightly ahead of its predicted position and then being slowed down by the Earth's gravitational tug repeats over and over again. Over time, this causes the moon's orbit to become larger and larger, which means that it moves farther and farther away from the Earth. It's important to note that the rate of lunar recession is not constant. It depends on a number of factors, including the location of the moon in its orbit and the position of the Earth's equatorial bulge. However, over millions of years, the effect is significant, and the moon has moved about 384,400 kilometers away from the Earth since it first formed. The gravitational pull of the moon causes the tides on Earth to rise and fall, but the opposite is also true. The tides on Earth exert a gravitational force on the moon. This force causes the moon to slow down in its orbit, which leads it to moving away from Earth. So to sum it up, the moon is moving away from Earth due to the gravitational interaction and tidal forces between the two bodies. But don't worry, this process is very slow and won't have any immediate impact on us. In fact, it will take billions of years for the moon to move far enough away from Earth to have a significant effect on our planet. But there are some interesting implications to consider. For instance, as the moon moves farther away from Earth, it will exert less of a gravitational pull on our planet. This could lead to changes in our climate and even affect the stability of Earth's axis of rotation. So while the moon's movement away from Earth may seem insignificant now, it's worth studying and understanding for the future of our planet. Let's see what happens if the worst-case scenario happens and the moon escapes the Earth's orbit. If the moon escapes Earth, it is important to note that this scenario is highly unlikely to occur anytime soon. The moon is currently moving away from the Earth at a rate of about 3.8 centimeters per year, but it would take billions of years for it to move far enough away to escape the Earth's gravity altogether. Nevertheless, let's consider the hypothetical consequences of the moon's disappearance. First thing, there would be changes in tides. One of the most notable effects of the moon's disappearance would be changes in the tides. The gravitational pull of the moon is responsible for the tides, which are caused by the Earth's rotation and the moon's gravitational force on the oceans. Without the moon, the tides would become smaller and less frequent. This could have a significant impact on marine ecosystems, as many species depend on the tides for their survival. The changes in tides caused by the moon's disappearance would not only impact marine ecosystems, but also have significant consequences for coastal regions and human activity. For example, the loss of high and low tides would affect the way that coastal landscapes are shaped and eroded. Tidal energy, which is currently being explored as a potential source of renewable energy, would also be impacted. The smaller and less frequent tides would mean that there would be less energy available to harness. In addition, the disappearance of the moon's gravitational pull would cause changes in ocean currents, which could have implications for global weather patterns. Ocean currents are responsible for regulating the distribution of heat across the planet and play a critical role in the climate system. Any disruption to these currents could cause significant changes in temperature and precipitation patterns, leading to droughts, floods, and other extreme weather events. Furthermore, the loss of the tides would impact the navigation of ships and boats, as well as the fishing industry. The tides currently help to regulate the movement of water in ports and harbors, and their disappearance would make these areas more susceptible to flooding and other risks. Second thing, there would be changes in climate. The moon's gravity also plays a crucial role in stabilizing the Earth's axial tilt, which affects the climate. The axial tilt of the Earth is responsible for the changing of the seasons, and it helps to regulate the distribution of sunlight across the planet. Without the moon's stabilizing influence, the Earth's axial tilt could become more unstable, leading to extreme climate changes and possible mass extinctions. There would also be changes in the rotation rate of the Earth. The moon's gravitational force on the Earth causes a slowing down of the Earth's rotation rate. Without the moon, the Earth's rotation rate could increase, leading to shorter days and longer nights. This could have significant impacts on agriculture, as plant growth is regulated by the amount of sunlight they receive. We would have an increased risk of asteroid impacts. The moon helps to protect the Earth from asteroid impacts by attracting and deflecting them away from Earth. Without the moon's gravitational influence, the Earth would be more vulnerable to asteroid impacts, which could have catastrophic consequences. The impact of a large asteroid could cause widespread destruction and even trigger a mass extinction event. But the moon's movement away from the Earth is not the only thing scientists are studying. There's also the question of how the moon's distance affects our relationship with other celestial bodies in our solar system. For example, the moon plays a crucial role in stabilizing Earth's orbit around the sun. As it moves away, this stabilization could be affected, leading to changes in our planet's climate and weather patterns. And there's also the question of how the moon's movement affects our ability to explore space. The moon has long been seen as a potential base for further space exploration, but as it moves farther away from the Earth, it becomes more challenging to reach. So as you can see, the moon's movement away from Earth has far-reaching implications that scientists are studying and exploring. But despite these potential challenges, the Moon remains a fascinating object in our sky, inspiring poets, scientists, and dreamers alike. As we continue to study and learn about the Moon, we will undoubtedly uncover even more mysteries and secrets about our universe. So the next time you look up at the Moon, remember that it's not just a beautiful object in the sky, but also a vital part of our relationship with the cosmos. Thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video, where we'll explore more fascinating discoveries about our universe. Don't forget to like, subscribe to our channel to stay tuned with our latest videos and most exciting subjects. Let us know in the comments what you think about these discoveries. We care about what you think.